In part one, we covered some tips and techniques for creating or rendering lightning over a black base coat. And I also showed you guys how you can add a hint of color into your lightning. For part two, I want to cover doing the same thing over a different colored base coat, anything other than black. David Parker, who requested these videos, is planning on painting some lightning over a model airplane wing that is a blue that fades into a black, and he wants a little bit of yellow in the lightning, and that's why I ultimately chose to use yellow. I've already sprayed a lightning bolt on this blue panel off camera just to speed the process up. I did the exact same thing as I showed you guys in part one to create this lightning, with one exception. Really, the only thing I did differently on this panel compared to the previous panel is I did add a little bit of a glow to these branched areas. And again, you don't have to add color to your lightning. This could easily be called finished as it sits, using only opaque white. It's completely up to you. We are going to add some yellow to this lightning bolt. It's the same candy mix that I used in part one, the same white mix that we used in part one. So let's get to spraying. Again, I'm going to use very light coats to begin building up this yellow color. And I'm not trying to only spray over the white background, because that's nearly impossible. Some of this yellow is drifting over into the blue. You can make this color as bright or intense as you want, or you can keep it very subtle. I'm not sure if the issue that I want to point out was showing up in that particular camera angle as I was painting this. In part one, we talked about why I chose to use a candy to tint the lightning on this panel. It's because candy is 100% transparent. It's dye-based. It doesn't have any pigment in it. The benefit to using candy over a black background is it disappears over the black. So we tinted all of the white, and we got candy over some of the black paint as well, but it disappears. Another attribute of a candy is it always darkens, regardless of what color candy you're using. Anytime you put a layer of candy over something, it's going to darken whatever is underneath it. That's what has happened here. So looking at this panel, you see a darker halo all around the lightning bolt. That's the candy overlapping the blue background. So the advantage of using a candy over a black base coat is you're working with a very dark background. Black is as dark as it gets. Black is the absence of light. You're not going to darken this black any further than it already is. So the candy just melts away when it gets off of our lightning bolt. That's not the case on a lighter color background, as you can plainly see here. That's not necessarily a bad thing. Some people may even like it. With certain colors, it works better than with others. For example, the yellow over this blue, I personally don't like it, but I could see how one could look at it and say, well, it looks more like the light is diffusing off into the background. So it may not necessarily be a huge issue for you and your project. Again, it's completely up to you as the artist. Having said that, it depends on what colors you're using, and this is where you need to have a good basic understanding of color theory. Because, for example, if we were to use a orange candy over this blue background, we would get a very different effect, because with orange and blue, you're essentially mixing the three primaries, and that would create a very dirty or muddy brown color or halo all the way around the lighting. So it depends on the colors that you're using, the color of the candy that you're using, as well as the background color that you are painting over. Because as airbrush artists, we mix paint in separate containers or in the airbrush cup, but you have to keep in mind you're also mixing paint on the canvas. That's exactly what I did by spraying this yellow candy over the blue background. Not only did we tint the white that we had in the lightning bolt, but we also tinted the background itself. And that can be a good thing or it can be a bad thing. Again, it's kind of up to you as the artist to decide if that's the effect you're looking for. So at this point, you can come back in with white and add a little bit more of a glow in the very center of this lightning bolt, and we'll do that really quickly and we'll see how that looks. You'll notice how I start off of the panel as well. Just like before, this is probably going to take a few coats to build it up. Some blowouts in there. Sometimes it's hard to spray these things with a camera right in my way. Just a little bit more of a glow there at the start of the bolt. Same thing with where these branches are coming off, just like we did before. Once again, this particular combination of colors doesn't look absolutely horrible. The yellow candy traveling over the blue background creates a very dark green halo that almost looks like the lightning is dissipating into the background or maybe even creating a shadow. And again, if you're using a different color of candy over a blue background, you'll get a very different result. So if you like this look, or this effect, then you can absolutely use the exact same techniques to get the same results. The same techniques we used in part one over the black background will work over other colored bases as well. What if you don't necessarily like this effect or the halo that you get around your lightning? Is there another way that we can work over different colored backgrounds and get rid of that effect or minimize it? Yes, there is, and it starts by using an opaque color other than white to begin with. In this case, I'm going to use Wicked Opaque Bismuth Yellow. So this is the same process that we covered in part one. The only difference is instead of using opaque white, I'm now using an opaque yellow. The reduction is roughly the same. It's about 2:1, two parts paint to one part 4011 reducer. And I will start out doing the same thing that I did with the white in part one of the video. So starting a little bit off of the panel to make sure the airbrush is spraying well, and it's not. Maybe it was my imagination. Okay, it's a buildup in the fluid nozzle. Starting off of the panel, you can see I got a couple of little spots there. That's okay. We'll cover those back up. Same as the white, this is an opaque color, but the coverage with water-based paint still needs a few coats to really build up the opacity. See how I'm kind of flooding some of this out? That's what I call flooding. What I'm doing is I'm actually releasing more paint. I'm pulling the trigger back farther on the airbrush and allowing the air pressure to push that paint out. Now I want to create the glow around this using the same technique. The difference is with this opaque yellow, I'm going to make the glow a little more pronounced because this is creating the glow. This opaque color is creating the glow versus a candy. Same thing we did last time. I can move the airbrush a little bit closer, not close enough to create a super fine lightning line, but it's allowing me to build that glow. that creates a lot of overspray. So I can take a paper towel, wipe the panel down, which is always a good idea. Keep your surface clean when you're working. And you can see some of the yellow on the paper towel. Not scrubbing, I'm just lightly rubbing the overspray off of the panel. So hopefully you can see the difference between using the opaque yellow over the blue background compared to the candy yellow over the blue background. The candy yellow creates that very dark halo all the way around this lightning bolt. You get a little bit of some diffusion as that opaque yellow dissipates into the blue, but it's not the same effect. This is much cleaner compared to the candy because you don't get that dark halo that travels beyond the actual lightning bolt. That's the difference when it comes to working over a different color background, something other than black. So now we can do the same thing that we did in the previous two examples, come back in with the white and add a highlight down the center of this lightning bolt. This is the same opaque white that we used before, starting off of the panel. What I'm trying to do here is keep this more or less receded. I want to keep the white within the opaque yellow that we've already created. Same as before, it'll take a couple of coats to build this to the opacity or the intensity that you want. Keeping this one thinner than I did on the previous two. Because that really sells that yellow glow around the lightning bolt. For the branches, I'll bring the white into them slightly and then I'll let the yellow fade out. Same thing, I can create a little bit of a hot spot with the white at the portions where everything forks off. Maybe right at the top. You can change this up however you see fit. The reason that I kept this white, the opaque white highlight or glowing portion of the lightning bolt on this side very thin compared to what we did on this side or even the panel that we did in part one is because if you choose to do so, you can still use the candy to come in and tint this white into a yellow. What you need to do though is make sure that you keep your candy within that opaque yellow background. If you get the candy outside of the opaque yellow, you're going to have the same issue that you had on this side of the panel, where you'll get the dark green halo coming around it. So to come in with the candy, you have to be very strategic in where you put the paint. You can do that, or you can leave it as is. It's up to you as the artist. I will go in with the candy just to demonstrate how you can do that. So I've gone back to the Lemon Yellow Candy 2.0, and again, before we were spraying very liberally. I wasn't worried about getting candy into the background. This time I'm going to be very strategic. I'm going to bring the airbrush in closer. I'm going to concentrate on only covering the opaque white. Still working in light layers. You can see, hopefully, that this is tinting that white to a yellow. It's up to you how much you want to tint this. Personally, I think it looks really good with just a slight yellow tint. Still keeping a little bit of the white showing through for the super bright areas. And you may get a little bit of candy onto the blue and a few very small areas. That's okay. For the most part, you want to try and keep the candy, again, within that initial opaque yellow color. So that is two very different examples of how you can create lightning over a different colored background. And again, you can pick and choose the colors, whether it's the background color you're working over, as well as the color that you want to tint your lightning, if you are going to tint your lightning into a color. The only other thing that I would normally do on this example that we've been working on is now I would come back in with the Wicked Opaque White one last time and put one more white bolt coming through the center. Again, keeping it very thin, and I'm not probably going to cover it multiple times. I just want a hint of that white to really brighten it up just a little bit more. So essentially what we've done is we've used the exact same techniques to create two very different looking lightning effects. And the first one on this side, we relied on a candy color to tint our lightning into that yellow color. But that also created that darker halo around the lightning bolt in the background. In this example, we relied on an opaque yellow color to create the yellow glow and the color in the lightning. This is a much cleaner transition when you're working over a color other than, say, black. But again, if you like this haloed look, and some colors it works really well, some colors it doesn't. Again, that comes back to having a good understanding or basic understanding of color theory and how your colors are going to mix on the actual canvas when you spray them. So pick and choose in these techniques and come up with your own style, the way that you want it to be done. You can change this up. Like in the second example, you could make that main lightning bolt a lot wider and brighter using just the opaque white as we did in this example or this example. At the end of the day, it's all up to you. I hope you guys got something out of this. If you did, remember to like, subscribe, and share. I'll leave links in the description below to all of the products that I used in this video. I'm Trevor with Wicked Arch Studio. I'll see you guys next time.